Hi, I'm Helle. Today I will play Lucidity Six-Sided Nightmares, and I will play the solo version of the game. The game is for 1 to 4 players at the ages 14 plus and takes about 20 to 30 minutes to play. And this is a pressure lock game, and we are trying to escape from creatures of the dream, or we can also become a nightmare, but not in the solo version. Only if we play with 2 to 4 players, then we can become a nightmare and hunt the others. So in the solo version, we will use this board. There are 4 different boards we can choose from, and there is an easy mode and the hard mode, and we will play the easy mode. And I have chosen Lady of Envy. And whenever we want to use one of our powers to reroll an unused die, an unresolved die, then we will have to place it up here on the spook track. And these spooks we have to deal with in the solo version. All players would receive a dream card, and we will also receive one in the solo version. And we will receive this marker. And each player will also receive these cards. And here we can see all the different phases. This phase is not active when you're playing the solo version, because we will not turn into a nightmare. And these 5 steps is the same if you're playing the solo version or if you're playing with more players. On this card we can see the different die faces for each color. And we want to roll these power symbols that has a number 1, or down on the red one we have one that has a number 2. Then we have these sleep, and we have these shadow die faces. And we have this hunt die face, which is only on the red die. These we would have to place here on the hunt track. If we ever fill up this row, then we would lose the game. And this goes for the solo version and if you're playing with more players. If we fill up one of these rows, then we would wake the corresponding monster, the corresponding nightmare of that color. And we have a blue, green, yellow and a red one. There are 4 different nightmares we can wake up in the game. And if we fill up a row a second time, then we lose the game. If we can manage to get up to 15 powers, in the solo version, or if you're playing with more players, you're trying to get up to 15 powers, then we will win the game. But in the solo version, we will very rarely get up to this 15 in powers, because we need to fight off all of these spooks, and we can use our powers to reroll spooks that are of the same color connecting. They can be connected vertically or horizontally, not diagonally. So these two are not connected, but these are. And at the end of each of our turns, we would these 2 dice, they will be placed on our board and they will not activate these effects. So a lot of bad dice will come from this Lady of Envy down to our dream board. I will explain more of the rules when we play the game. So let's start the game. And I will use this one from another game as our dice tray. Place it here. And we have 80 dice, 20 of each color, and I have already drawn randomly from the bag and placed dice here with the shadow face showing. So the first thing I have to do, I have to choose a sleep track. And we have 3 sleep tracks. And we have a bit easier, medium and a hard one. Or more risky, if you can say so. Because here we would have to take 3 dice, 4 dice and 5 dice. I will start on the risky one and draw 5 dice from the bag. And then I have to choose 2 of the dice and put back into the bag. And I would like to get a green one, because if I can get a green power, I will be able to reroll these 2. So I think I will take 1 more. We only have 1 yellow out here, so I don't think I will take that one. And I want the red one. There are 2 here we could reroll. I think I'll take these 2 and place back into the bag. And now we have to roll these, and I would like to get some powers, some numbers. So let's see what we can do. There. And we got a little of different things here. The next thing we have to do, we have to resolve our dreams. First, we will resolve all of our powers. So all our powers we will place down here. Then, if we had any hunt, we don't. If we had any sleep, we don't. And then we will have to take these shadow dice. And I can choose in which order I want to take them. And when we place this green die, we have to re-roll one dream of next player's choice. And these dice, they are called dream. So it's any card, it's any die on our dream board that he could say, the next player could say, we would have to re-roll. When you play the solo version, you will have to take your first power in your row and re-roll that die. So unfortunately, I'll have to re-roll this die. But hopefully, I will get a one again. And we did. Then you can take this one and place. You may move one of your shadow to your hunt. So one of them was closed at getting to four in a row, I could move one of them to the hunt track. And I can now spend my powers to reroll some of these spooks. So I will spend this power to reroll these two. They are connected. And if I get any powers, they will be returned to the bag. And all other die faces, they will be put back on the track. We got not one, and we got one. We got two, number one. So they will both be returned to the bag. And we got rid of two of these spooks. We will move the others down. And now we have three blue connected here and three blue here. So we would like to get a blue power to reroll some of these blue spooks. Now I can choose to rest, or I can choose to take one more turn. And I think I will take one more turn. We only have two dice out here. We need to get rid of some of all these spooks. So I will draw seven dice now. Wow, a lot of yellow, but of course we don't have any out here. I would like the red, so we could re-roll some of those. And we have to take some of all of these yellow, I think. Should we do it like this? I think we'll do like this and return one green and one yellow. Then we have to hopefully get a lot of powers. We got three powers. That was awesome. So we will put the powers down here. And one sleep. And then this one, we can move one up here if we want to. I don't think I want to. I just think I will spend some of my powers. But both of these colors, we only have one, but I can try. We could get rid of a die, couldn't we? So I will try this one and reroll the yellow one we have here. And what did we get? We got a one, so we will remove this one and move these down. And then I think I will spend the green power to reroll one of the green. Maybe I think I'll take this one. Yeah. We got a one again. Wow. Awesome. Then. Oh, we got a lot of blue dice coming up here. And now I can choose if I want to rest or if I want to draw nine dice. I think I will rest. And when I rest, I get to choose to remove all dice that has this sleep on it or one shadow die. And I think I will remove this red one and put it back to the back. And then in the solo version, these two will enter our board and they will not activate. They will just enter the board and be placed on the track. And then we will start a new turn. And we can see we will get a red and a blue. And there's a lot of blue dice. So we would like to get rid of some of the blue dice. Or get a blue die so we could reroll all of these. Now, where do we want to go this time? I think I will go... I will go with number four. I will take the medium risky track this time. And draw four dice. We didn't get a blue die. But we did get a red, so we could maybe reroll these, and we could move one of those over here if we get a red shadow die. I think we will take both of the red ones. And maybe that's a bit risky, but I'll try it. Hopefully we'll get some powers. We got one power and one to the hunt track. If we get three more, then we would lose the game, so we have to be careful. We have to check for filled rows. We don't have any. Then I will spend this one and roll these two dice. If we wake up a nightmare, and then we can only win the game if we have two powers per nightmare we have awakened when we end the game, when we have finished this track, when we have gone through this track and it's empty, then we will see if we are still alive. And if we have awakened a nightmare, we have to have two powers for each nightmare we have awakened. So hopefully we won't get to that. Ooh, that wasn't good. What did I hope? I shouldn't do this. We re-roll these. They will get out here. Why am I confused now? No. Alright, this one will go here. So now we have two on the hunt track and we can't move them. And I can go here and I could move one over here, but that would be simply too risky. I won't do that. I think I will just rest and put a blue die back to the back. And then these will come down to the board. And a new turn. I think we will start here again. And I will draw four dice. That is okay, I think. I will take the two yellow dice, I think. Yeah, the two yellow dice. And I will roll those. And we got a power and a sleep. Power and a sleep. If we get one more sleep, then we would our turn would end. I think I need to rest again. But we also have a lot of those red down there. I think I need to rest and remove one red die. And then these will come on to the board. Oh, we have three and three and two here. It is getting more risky now, I think. Maybe we should chicken out and go down here and only draw three dice. Three yellow. So we will choose one yellow die. And let's see what we get. We got a sleep. This means that our turn will end, but we have to draw one die from here. And it was a blue. So all blue powers we would have to return to the bag. If I had gotten a yellow one, then these two would have been returned to the bag. So luckily I didn't get a yellow. And I think I will... I don't think so. I have to rest now. And these three... I will put these three back into the bag. All with a sleep mark on them, I can put back into the bag. So these three. And then this one will go down and this one will go down. So if I don't manage to get rid of this, and I don't think I will manage, then we will wake the blue nightmare. And we need to have two powers to win the game when we get rid of these two. Okay. I think I will just draw three dice again. We already have four here, so I could just take this one. It's already bad. Or I could just take this yellow. Okay, I can't do anything about these two. I think I'll just take this yellow one. And roll that one. And we got a number one. And then I could rest and remove that one, but it will be overrun anyway. I could do it. I could remove this one. No, I can't. We have to check for filled rows first. So now we have to check for filled rows. This one is filled. So we will wake up the blue monster. So he will wake up. You put him up here. And this ability does not have any effect when we play the solo version. There's an ability on the card. It's when if you become a nightmare when you play two or four players, then you will get these things. Then you will get all the blue dice with a shadow face showing. And these three, they will be returned to the back. I think I will just rest and remove this one. and then these two are filled to our board. And we have emptied the row, so we did wake up one nightmare, then we need to have two powers, we have three powers, so we did win the game in this case, even though we did wake up a nightmare. If we had two more blue dice here, then we would have lost. But we managed to win the game, and I played the easy mode of the game, so you can make it even harder and play the hard mode of the game. And I don't think, did I get to place any blue dice? I don't think so. If you place a blue die here, then you have to draw a die and roll it. Not when you do it with the shadow here. I can't remember if I did that in the game. And yeah, that I think we were through the other abilities. So that was Lucidity. It's a pressure luck game. And if you're playing with more players, then each player, they will have their own dream card. And you wouldn't use this side of the board. You would have, all players would have their own dream card. And if a player turns into a nightmare, they will place the nightmare here. And then they will get to collect dice. And the blue player will be able to actually, in their turn, there are two actions you can choose from. You can choose to take one power from all the other players. It can both be from a nightmare player or from a dream player, and then places to your own power track. And all players, they are competing to getting up to 15 powers. And if there aren't any blue dice you can collect, then you can draw two dice and give one to a player and make them roll the die. And if they roll, or each of these, they have a special ability. And if they roll what this it says on the board card here, then you may take that die and place it as a power number one on your board. So you will be collecting all the blue dice when you are the blue nightmare. And if you are the yellow nightmare, you would of course collect the yellow dice, and the red would collect the red dice. And here, if you take a number two power from a player, then you will only get to place it as a number one on your board and not as a number two power. And we have the yellow there, and then we have the green that will go for all the green dice. But that was an example of how to play this game as a solo version, and the rules is pretty much the same when you play with more players. You can just become a nightmare, and you will become a nightmare the first time you fill up a row. And you will still lose the game if you get 4 hunt tokens. I hope you got a feeling of how the game is played. And this game is really a press your luck game. And it's a pretty quick game. Thanks for watching. Bye.